Superstar American actress Kate Walsh, who famously plays Dr. Addison Montgomery in Grey's Anatomy, has found a brand new home in Perth. Since settling on our Aussie shores, she's wasted no time diving into the local theatre scene and now stars in a production called Mary Stuart. The stage show tells the tale of the legendary Mary, Queen of Scots, and Elizabeth I of England. I caught up with Kate to hear all about it.
Yeah, I'm super excited. We're going to be doing Mary Stuart. We'll start previewing February 8th and open on the 11th for Perth Festival. For a story about two, albeit British, queens, couldn't be more Australian. It's adapted by Kate Mulvaney, and who's obviously a very extraordinary actress, but an incredible playwright. So we have a brilliant script. Caroline Brazier is reprising her role as Mary Stuart. And we have Mel Cantwell directing and an incredible cast and crew of Aussies that are, it's just one of the things that I'm very excited about and was super stimulated by Perth is the theater community here. Just the level of talent and expertise and commitment and passion, and it's been like being in a candy shop.
How did you end up in Perth, for those who don't know the story?
I know, they're like, why are you here? Well, I came here just to have a little visit, you know, in March 2020, about 2 days before the global pandemic hit and the borders locked. I was supposed to be here for 2 weeks and then ended up staying for about 15 months before I went back home to work. My partner's here. I've got a cat giving me the stink eye. He came from New York too, and so did Rosie the dog. She's out on a dog walk. She's waiting in the river right now with her pack of geriatric dogs. But so that's why I'm here.
It's a rule for we Australian entertainment reporters, when anyone spends this significant amount of time here, we demand that we hear your Australian accent. So fire away.
I don't think I've got a very good one.
I reckon.
I'd say yeah, no. I don't think I really have much of an Australian accent. It's more things like yeah, nah. And hey, I say hey a lot. Yeah. And then things like the kind of, you know, jumpers and bins instead of, you know, sweaters and garbage cans, all that kind of stuff.
Footpath, not sidewalk. You're getting the idea.
Yeah. Yeah. Nobody knows
where they might end up. You mentioned that you popped back to do some work. That work was popping back into the latest season of Grey's Anatomy. What was it like going back? And I hear you bumped into McDreamy, who gave you a bit of advice on going back.
Oh, that's funny. Yeah, I did. I went back to shoot Grey's. I was on my way back from Paris. I was shooting Emily in Paris, and on the flight there was Patrick. So I went and had a little chat. He was like, oh, you're going to melt emotionally. You're just going to freak out because it's such a trip to go back. He had already done his return, of course. It was really very moving and really emotional. He was right. It was great, though. It was beautiful, and it was a great script, and it was just like this strange fever dream of seeing Ellen again and, you know, Laura Petticord, who runs our base camp, all of our crew that have been there since the very beginning. There's people that have raised their children on that show, and it's very meaningful. I mean, Linda Klein, our OR nurse, who made me on my very first day of work 18 years ago, where I'm supposed to be an expert surgeon, and my hands are shaking, and she's the one who made me look like I knew what I was doing, and so that we're not an embarrassment to the medical community.
Hello, were you Daddy's friend?
I was, yes. Be some
brighter day. What's in store? Can you give us any little hints?
It was written by one of my oldest friends, Jamie Denbo, who I knew in New York in the improv comedy scene. So this was back in the late 90s in New York, where we used to be in an all-women's improv group and with Amy Poehler and Tina Fey, and it was just a really iconic time. But he called me Addie. And then here she is writing on Grey's, and she wrote the first episode that I go back in. And it is just, what I can tell you is it's classic, iconic Grey's. The fans will not be disappointed with Addison's return. And then the second episode with Katerina deals with the pandemic a little bit.
Speaking of the pandemic, there is a great meme going around at the moment, and it says, remember back in season one of COVID when we thought maybe we'd be in this for just five seasons like Breaking Bad, and now it's like, surprise, y'all, this is Grey's Anatomy.
Yeah, it made me laugh.
It's spot on, isn't it?
Addison, he is here. And he's seen his children. And they are very real.
so proud of Ellen. That was one of the most emotional things about going back, was seeing her. And I could cry thinking about it because she's just such a powerhouse. We were all like little pups starting that show and experiencing the mad success of it together, both critically and culturally and worldwide then. And to see her raise her kids and become a real leader, like it's her show. It's, and she's directed episodes and she's producing. It's really incredible.
You mentioned earlier that you'd done this comedy improv work with Tina and Amy and those sort of guys. Do you ever do stand-up? Have you thought of jumping up at one of the great comedy clubs here in Australia and doing stand-up?
Oh, that's funny. I did do stand-up for a bit. And then I got to this place where I was shooting 13 Reasons Why and then doing a movie, Felt, in Georgia, in Atlanta. And I went and did a club there. And he's like, we can headline you if you come back. It was too hard for me to switch, especially doing 13 Reasons Why and playing that role.
Yeah, that's a bit of a contrast.
I'm rambling, but yeah, that's a long answer to your question. I would love to do something here. I know Sasha Baron Cohen was here doing some live stuff. I mean, it would be fun to do something here. And Jim Jeffries is a good mate of mine, and I'm like, that'd be really fun.
The main thing is we get to see you live treading the boards in Mary Stuart.
I won't look like this. Just if anybody's watching, this is not what you're gonna see there.
You can catch the incredible Kate Walsh with a bit of a higher hairline in Mary Stuart at the State Theatre Centre of WA from next Wednesday through to February 25. For tickets, head to ptt.wa.gov.au.